Shri Gurubhyo Namaha, children. You are in Unit 8 Financial Statement Analysis. Right? Now, today I am going to teach you how to do your realization problem number 10. Now, we have a common balance sheet of two people, Sharmila Limited and Sangeeta Limited, as on 31st March 2019. Right? They have given you the particulars of the balance sheet, equity, liability, and then you have shareholders fund, a non-current liability, current liability, non-current assets, and then current assets. Total assets, you have Sharmila Limited and Sangeeta Limited, right? So you have Sharmila with this total and Sharmila and Sangeeta with this total of liabilities, and then assets you have 10 lakhs and then 10 lakhs, right? So common size statement of Sharmila Limited as on 31st March, let us proceed with the problem. Now we have actually Sharmila's amount. Let us copy Sangeeta's amount also so that we can proceed with the problem. Okay. Now absolute amount is 11 lakhs. Okay, 7 lakhs for non-current liabilities, 2 lakhs for your current liabilities, right? 2 lakhs for your current liabilities. So, total comes to 20 lakhs. Fine. Let's see what your asset is. Non-current assets, 18 lakhs and then 2 lakhs. So, 18 lakhs. And then 2 lakhs, your current assets. The total comes to 20 lakhs. Right? Okay, there you are. So now let us find out the common size balance sheet of both parties, Sharmila and Shakila. Right? Sharmila and Shakila. Fine. Now let us get into the problem. Okay, children, there you are. I wanted the full screen. Fine. Now, the percentage of Sharmila and Sangeeta. Now, let us assume that this is going to be our base, total liabilities, and then total assets. This is going to be our base. So, percentage is going to be 100. And now, you're supposed to calculate your shareholders fund in relation to your liabilities. 4 lakhs in relation to your liabilities, isn't it? Your 10 lakhs. So let us calculate that. 5 lakhs. First one, first calculation, 5 lakhs into 100 divided by 10 lakhs. Okay, 10 lakhs. So be careful with your zeros. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. So percentage is 50. Next, you have 40. 44 lakhs you have, 4 lakhs into 100 divided by 5 lakhs, divided by 10 lakhs, not 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just 40%. Then again you have 10 lakhs divided by 10 lakhs into 100, 10 lakhs. Divided by 10 lakhs into 100. So that is going to be 100%. Okay. Now let us come to our non-current assets. That is 6,50,000. Your base is going to be your total assets. So you can find, see this percentage, a percentage of total assets in relation to the shareholders fund in relation to the total assets is 50%. So now here 6,50,000 into 10 lakhs into 100. So 10 lakhs. So 1, 2, 3, 4 into 3, 4 is 65%. Now 3,50,000 divided by 10 lakhs into 100. So again you have 5 years. So 35%. Okay guys, now next you have your 11 lakhs into 100 divided by 20 lakhs. So 1, 2, 3, into 5, that comes to 55%. Fine. Next you have 7 lakhs divided by 20 lakhs into 100. You have 20 lakhs, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, isn't it? Seven fives are 35. Okay, then you have 2 lakhs divided by 20 lakhs into 100. So that comes to 10%. Right. Next, you have your there's some states here we can replace that. 18 lakhs. You can do it in your working column, and I want to have all this in one page to be easy for you to understand. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You will go here. Amitas, 50. This is 18 lakhs, right? 18 lakhs. This is 20 lakhs. So 1, 0 will go off. Okay. There's a 40. 90%. Fine. So it's understood the balance will be 10% here. Then you got 2 lakhs divided by 20 lakhs into 100. So, right. So 10%. Fine. So that's it. We found out the percentage of our the other items in relation to our total assets. Thank you, children. We just finished our 10th illustration. I'll be teaching exercise 10 now. Thank you.